How are you? This is Soul Survivor from Exile on Main Street, the vinyl version, not the compressed to hell and back version that of subsequent CD releases. This is from the 2000, what's on the DAWs, so the 2010 reissue with the 10 bonus tracks. Look at that thing. You ever hear of the Loudness Wars? You can look into that, because that is brick walled. Below it, I just have a track for comparison. I guarantee that the original track more like this, or tracked more like this than this. This is Bob Clearmountain, whoever mastered, whatever mastering engineer, just turning everything up, putting a compressor on it, and well, bye-bye clarity. That's unfortunate, because there's some things on here that are pretty cool that you can't hardly ever, you don't even hear anymore. Unless you got a good stereo, like I do, and vinyl, like I do. And so I'll play some of it. It's open G. Did I already say this? Five strings? Some more, but it starts with this shape. That's the E note and the G note. The next move is to hammer on this so you can get the sound of the hammer on the C note so you can get the sound of the C and the D together. And it's at this point you add the E flat and then release it. And then to the open strings and then the A and the C. So slowly. One more time. Then you get this cool thing. The B note and then the D drone. Like this. And while that thing is droning, and Keith uses a lot of drones on Exile on Main Street. This one on Rocks Off, one on Casino Boogie. While that thing's droning, then you're fingering these three notes and playing that same suspension. Then the drone is killed when you move to the B flat. Then it's played one more time. To the C. Cutthroat Crew to the F. And the B flat suspension. The C and the F suspension. The F and the B flat suspension. Then it goes to the B flat, but not before going to a G. So you're here and it's. You're listening to this, and I'm talking about the 2010 or CD versions, and it sounds like this. But it's. His autobiography, there's a paragraph about him talking about his propensity for adding that open chord. You know, as long as the chord is a, or as long as the open, this is a G. If it was E or D, you know, he does this in between the other chords. Fattens it up. Oh, and then there's the part that was on, that's on Soul Survivor and ended up, it was played again on Undercover, that song, It Must Be Hell. And that too has this little, they'll play this slowly. He doesn't do that every time, but he does it enough to notice it. That happens around 121, 123, something like that. Here it goes. 7. And then it's the last, going to be the death of me, which skips the C. It skips the C and the F suspension and goes from the B flat to the E flat. But there's the G chord in there. Pretty cool. So that's and sometimes Zen, the Rolling Freaking Stones, the world's greatest rock and roll band, baby. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to write.